from Los Angeles. This is Montserrat Radio.
November 8, 2017. FBI raids Hillary Clinton death factory as more deep state Trump attacks exposed. A stunning new Foreign Intelligence Service SVR report circulating in the Kremlin today states that Federal Bureau of Investigation FBI forces loyal to President Donald Trump have just conducted a massive raid against one of the largest body part death factories in the U.S. after it was linked to both Hillary Clinton and CIA gunrunner and human smuggler Stephen Paddock, who was the designated patsy for the Las Vegas massacre. While at the same time, the deep state attacks against Trump over his supposed collusion with Russia are now being called an embarrassment to America after they're being exposed for the lies they really are. Note some words and/or phrases appearing in quotes in this report are English language approximations of Russian words, phrases having no exact counterpart. According to this report, during the past 24 hours, FBI forces from both Las Vegas and Washington, D.C. joined with their counterparts in Portland, Oregon, and descended en masse upon one of America's largest wholesalers of human body parts named MedCure, whose business is described as soliciting thousands of Americans to donate their bodies to science each year, and who then profits by dissecting the parts and distributing them for use by researchers and educators throughout the world. MedCure was founded in 2006 by David Urbina and Janice Losenox, this report details, but became highly concerning to FBI investigators in Washington, D.C. when they discovered that the international law firm Perkins Coie had been paying over $100,000 a year to a Beaverton, Oregon company named Wood Furniture PDX, whose sole owner is MedCure founder Janice Losenox, with its supposed woodworking factory location at 4016 Southwest 96th Avenue, Beaverton, Oregon, being no such thing as it's a single residence mansion valued at over $550,000, with it also being important to note that Perkins Coie was directed by both the Democratic National Committee and Hillary Clinton's campaign to retain Fusion GPS, in April of 2016, to compile the fake Russian dossier on President Trump. While FBI investigators in Washington, D.C. were becoming highly concerned as to why Hillary Clinton's law firm was paying MedCure founder Janice Losenox hundreds of thousands of dollars, this report continues, FBI investigators in Las Vegas, at the same time, became shockingly alarmed after they discovered that CIA gunrunner and human smuggler Stephen Paddock made regular deliveries to the MedCure facility in Henderson, Nevada, and though SVR intelligence analysts do not suggest that Paddock was using MedCure as a body dumping station, they do stunningly note that Nevada has the worst laws governing human remains in the entire U.S., whose elected or appointed sheriffs are mandated by law to be coroners, even without medical education, and who are also the sole determiner as to the cause of death, thus making this state the perfect, ideal location to rid oneself of the unwanted bodies of those killed during illegal human smuggling operations. As these FBI forces loyal to President Trump continue closing in on Hillary Clinton, and all of her criminal accomplices, too, this report says, the deep state's defense of her by falsely claiming Trump had colluded with Russia has now collapsed into what is now being compared to a hound of the Baskervilles chasing its tail event, where the hound has caught its own tail and devoured itself from behind to the point that it has become a deformed biped and is now making America the laughingstock of nations the world over. To why the entire world is laughing at these insane Americans, this report explains, is due to their all knowing the most important simple fact underlying the entire Trump-Russia deep state fairy tale, and which is the two central pillars of this fable: the Democrats being hacked, and the Russia dossier, were entirely made-up lies bought and paid for by Hillary Clinton and her Democrats in order to soothe their being defeated by President Trump. Where in normal times such nonsensical claims of Trump colluding with Russia would have been relegated to the dustbin of history where it belonged, this report details, the American people were, instead, blindsided by their propaganda mainstream media that operates as the communications arm of the Democratic Party, and who were shockingly being paid by Hillary Clinton's Russia dossier creator Fusion GPS to spread these made-up lies as if they were truth, with many of these supposed mainstream journalists also being on the direct payroll of Fusion GPS itself. Even to the deep state's supposed triumph of discovering that a Russian lawyer had met with top Trump officials before the election, this report continues, even it has now been exposed as being a setup, as this lawyer has now been discovered to have met with Hillary Clinton's fake Russia dossier firm Fusion GPS both prior to, and after, this meeting occurring. Though the highly respected and award-winning international affairs journalist Joel Oria attempted to warn the readers of the leftist Huffington Post that Hillary Clinton's cash for trash fake Trump-Russia collusion fairy tale was all made up. This report says, the Huffington Post quickly deleted his article and replaced it with one accusing former Democratic National Committee leader Donna Brazile of now colluding with Russia and whose journalistic perceptions have become so acute, SVR analysts are warning that the Huffington Post may soon discover that President Putin has ties to Russia too. Failing to see any humor at all in this entire Russia hysteria mess created by Hillary Clinton and her leftist mainstream propaganda media allies, though, this report concludes, is CIA Director Mike Pompeo, who has just met, under orders from President Trump, with one of the most feared by the deep state U.S. intelligence officials in America today, named William Binney, who, along with other top U.S. intelligence officials, provided Trump with the proof that the DNC hadn't been hacked by Russia, with CIA Director Pompeo, afterwards, then taking what is being called the unusual step of having the CIA's Counterintelligence Mission Center, which would likely play a role in any inquiries by the agency.
In the spirit of the war against fake news, Montserrat Radio presents The Fake News Show. Conspiracy news and a different point of view of current events. And now your host, Benny Wilson.
Welcome to the Fake News Show, and yes, I'm still sick, but I'm going. Welcome to the Fake News Show, a special edition. This is the show that we can talk about things that are not related to the DRB, but we're still going to mention some stuff, some intel from the DRB, because everybody wants to get paid, right? So, as you listen, that was a intel being filtered in YouTube, and you probably will say, why would Benny listen to this crap when there's a robot talking? Well, the reason why I pay attention to this intel is because you need to understand this is deep state. So when somebody give an infiltered information like this in a way that you cannot even recognize who's talking about, is because he's covering up. Okay? That's the reason why. Am I saying that every single moron out there who put their YouTube stuff with a stupid sound or robot, it is his truth? No, it's not. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that you need to pay attention, because the biggest fall from people in general, they keep forgetting the time. They keep forgetting when the intel was given, and when it happens, and you probably listen afterwards, and you're saying, this is not truth. But this intel was provided weeks ago before it happened. So now we're seeing all these things happening right now. So I leave it up to you. See, one of the things that you need to understand, my show was previously not created for the DRB. I had the show designed for conspiracy news. And I was in the middle to basically just do conspiracy shows. But since I got into the middle of giving intel, I said to myself, well, let me do this. Because as long as I call my show the Fake News Show, I'll be okay. I'm still okay. You know? Because the establishment silences you in a way that you have no idea. It is amazing how this deep state have control of the information. Now, the things that are going to develop in days to come are going to be tremendous, because you need to understand this and you need to remember this, that all these things were prophesied, believe it or not. This is the reason why I keep telling people, let me get this off. This is the reason why I keep telling people that it makes more sense to listen to prophecy than the family in China. Now, within my own chat, they are sharing this stuff over people in China, showing people that they say, you know, I'm starting this to make a new republic. All that is a bullcrap. Okay? The new republic, it is not something that you're trying to promote. Nesara is not something that is got to be implementing. Everybody just going to grab their own hand and leave their way out. There is no such a thing like that. You need to use your logic. Use your brain. There is no stupid law that will obligate the establishment to grab their own hand and leave the Congress of the House of Representatives and just say, okay, because you guys have a law on quitting. No. Use your brain. Okay? Use your brain. I need to be so specific. And this is the reason why people attack me, because I call people retards. You are a retard if you believe that there's such a law that will obligate. Are you kidding me? How can you obligate more than 800 people in the government? How can you obligate for everybody just quit and leave Donald Trump, which is the most hated president we ever have from the establishment? There is no such a thing as a Nesara law or Gesara law. Nesara and Gesara, it is an agenda, not a law, retards. Yes, I call you a damn retard because you keep believing in fairy tales. The Nesara and Gesara is an agenda led by the new elite that was written and signed back in 1995. I said it before, and now I'm basically confirming it. Back in 1994, the new elite in power right now, which I'm not going to mention their name because for a long time I did not know their name. Now I know it, but I'm not going to mention their name. And the reason why I'm not going to mention the name is because I don't want to get in trouble. Okay? So, but I can guarantee you that the new elite is not like the good guys like everybody think, because they will say, oh, it's the family dragon. No. Okay? They have a different agenda. Am I saying is the good agenda? No, I'm not saying it's the good agenda. Am I saying it's a bad agenda? No, I'm not saying it's a bad agenda. We're just trying to decode it and trying to find out what exactly is their agenda, because they screwed it up in the past. You see, many of their agenda purposes and plans, they were destroyed. They're only keeping one agenda alive right now. And I told you which one is it. It was reported by The Economist. They're going to implement the climate change beginning 2018. That's it. They only have that. Even the World War III is collapsing. It's collapsing. That the only thing they have left now is the climate change, because they still have control. into this weapon called HARP. Now, you need to understand why Trump doesn't know about these HARP things, because for one thing, he's not aware of, believe it or not. He needs to deal with the enemy living in the house of the enemy. He's against a machine. And that machine is being destroyed right now. The only support that he has is our armed forces. Our armed forces are the same people who signed that agreement back in 1995 with Bill Clinton. Because they told Bill Clinton, you either give us the law, the Nassara law, implemented at the end of your presidency, or we're going to overthrow you, or we're going to go to a civil war. Because the army, the armed forces, is an elite in itself. They are types of elite, the one who has money, the one who has politic power, and the one who has the weapon. Those are the three major elites. So you need to understand how things work out. I have always tell people, do you really want to know how elites work? Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't you go and see the movie or the series of Game of Thrones? Yes, I tell people, go and see the series of Game of Thrones. Believe it or not, it will show you how the elites move around, how those kingdoms move around. They pull the strings, they go to bed with somebody, with the enemy, etc., etc. Believe it or not, that's the same thing happens right now. Okay? This is the same thing happens right now. So those things are moving around because the new reality is coming. The new reality is that you will see yourself with more purchasing power, but you're also going to get in your hands more responsibility, because you are the one who are going to be the next elite. With more purchasing power comes more responsibilities. With more purchasing power, it comes a lot of more things to do. You're not going to just be sitting there and just wait until you get older and die. And the reason why you're not going to be able to sit in there is because the conditions are going to change. I keep telling people, you are not being born to be unproductive. You were born to be productive. If you really want to do something for this planet, you got to get your butt out and do the dirty work. Almost 80% of all the people who has these so-called humanitarian projects, they're just that. They have no idea exactly what the hell they're talking about. Why? Because they're just looking for the humanitarian project bullcrap just for them to save themselves some money in taxes. That it is the truth. And I know many people are going to be really pissed out of me. I don't care. Somebody's got to tell you the truth. I have said that you do not need to wait for this blessing to come out to you. You can actually do it right now, and it probably will not even cost you any money. Why? How? Would you get yourself up there and be a, you know, be somebody who can want to help people. Hey, can I help you? You know, can I help you to do something to give food to the poor? You know, do something. Get yourself involved so you, by the time you get your blessing, you know what you're going to do. But there's people over here who has never, ever, ever, ever helped the poor people at all. And they just saying, oh, you know, I want to do this and this. And then they don't do crap. I have spoke a lot of people like that. They don't know nothing about helping people. Nothing. This is the reason why I get involved with churches. Because churches, they know what they want to do with the people. They're involved in the community. They know what the community needs. That's why many churches are involved in this. It's not because they want to be filtered rich. It's because they want to see some changes in their neighborhoods, in the cities. They are going to be the main elite in the nation. They will be, trust me what I'm telling you, in the near future, if any people running for president do not get the trust of the church, he will not be voted. He will not be elected. Believe it or not. Believe it or not. Churches, there will be a big organization of churches, all of them together, regardless of the denomination. They're all going to get together because that's the new elite. And it's going to be so strong. They will decide who's going to be the president and who's not. Why? Because they notice that if they don't do that, another pervert is going to be in office and destroy our country. You cannot have a nation coming to a good future while you're providing secret agendas that will eventually destroy us. Okay? See, this is the reason why many people call me a fanatic religious. Because they don't understand crap of what's going on. So right now, I'm going to talk about the diamonds. Are they truth or just rumors? And I got the evidence here. And I'm going to let you know. I'm going to let you decide if it is truth or rumor. Okay? All right. So, the first one that I want to bring it up is this one. It's all over the news in the Netherlands. Okay? It's about the... I found it here. Oh, here it is. It's all around the Netherlands. Okay, it's about the U.S. Marine stormed the CIA headquarters at Langley. Okay, reports of the U.S. Marine Expeditionary Unit lands at Langley to 22,000 Marines. Okay, so let me just tell you why is this evidence. Hey, 3 days ago, somebody reported this. It was going to happen. And I'm going to mention who it was. But you all know this. Somebody reported this 3 days ago. And now it happened. How did they know this was going to happen? Because they know information from deep sources. Okay, let me read it. And I'm going to explain to you why these things are happening. Did they tell you there's a secret coup against Donald Trump? You betcha. That's the reason why I keep telling everybody, keep praying for our president. Keep praying for our president. Because he's destroying every single pedophile ring and criminals. There are a lot of corruption in our government. Prophets like King Clement mentioned it. When a prophet like King Clement, which basically been the most accurate prophet in the history of our nation and probably in the world, said that there will be a day when he finished, meaning Donald Trump, leaving our government and will never be corrupted again, is because it's corrupted. It is filthy corrupted. All these wars we've been basically fighting, it's been because of corruption. They invented, they made it up, they've been doing it for a long time, and now it's done, it's over. This is why Democrats hate to see Donald Trump be friendly with Putin, be friendly with Chinese, because they don't like that. They want to keep us with the enemy all the time. If it is not them, it is another Osama Bin Laden. If it is not Obama, Osama Bin Laden, it is this idiot in ISIS, Baghdadi. They will always bring up somebody so we can go after them. And that's the reason they manipulate us. They basically bring us into this eternal war condition. That's their agenda. Eternal war condition. So let me read that news. Reports are beginning to surface that a Marine Special Unit, MEU, landed at Langley on Saturday. A Marine Special Unit, pronounced MEU, is the smallest Marine Air Ground Task Force of the United States Fleet Marine Forces, a special quick reaction force deployed and ready to immediate response to any crisis. The element, a composite medium tiltrotor squadron for the aviation combat element, a combat logistic battalion, provides the logistics combat element in the company size. Command element serves as the MEU headquarters group. Okay, so basically it tells you what are they doing. So according to the person who resides near Langley, a large contingent of Marines arrives at the CIA headquarters and they arm and move quickly into the CIA headquarters. Why they move quickly to the CIA headquarters? Let me remind you the two most corrupted branches we have, the FBI and the CIA. Okay? The CIA is probably the most corrupted branch we have. So they're going to either clean it up the good way or the bad way. All right? So right now you see the cleaning the swamp. They're actually cleaning the swamp. And Donald Trump has said it, he has openly said it, that he has the total support of the armed forces. Every single, even corrupted captains and colonels, they cannot even try to make a military coup against Donald Trump, because even the soldiers are, the big majority are supporting a president. So that's a good thing. Who made these people move their ass and clean the swamp? It was not the White Hats or the Family Dragon, your retard. It was the American people, followed by the Spirit of my Lord Jesus Christ, your moron and retard. It was Christ working for our country, and you have so much problem believing because you are so much busy praising the enemy of God. So don't get mad for calling you a retard, because you are what you are. I'm lifting you up, I'm not putting you down. This is what you need to read and need to analyze how things are working. I've been saying it all the time. You need to just sit down, shut up, and see how God is working for us. Every single people who are listening to my show, that they have their own children on the military, can tell me, are they being moved because a stupid fucking Chinese is telling you to clean it up? No. They're doing it because they love their country and they love their Lords of Lords, God of God, Jesus Christ. That's why they're doing it. So don't fucking tell me about their family fucking Chinese. You fucking retard. Stop it. So there you go. This is the same thing that I've been saying all the time. This is what pissed me off, because I just cannot slap you and then say, wake up. Wake up, man. Can you just see in front of you who's working for you? But you know what? I cannot do anything for you to just switch your mind. You've been brainwashed for more than 12 years. That's what you have been doing. You've been brainwashed for more than 12 years about this stupid family doing everything for you. They're the benevolence. Oh, no, don't even touch the extraterrestrial, Benny, because you're an asshole. Don't even do that, okay? Stop it. That's you. I had a moron insulting me because I called the extraterrestrials bullshit. He told me, don't even dare do that. I'm going to tell them that you're insulting them. Don't. And he sounded like a faggot. Shut the fuck up, idiot. I'm pissed because everybody's brainwashed. I got people brainwashed in front of me. I might be, and this is something that a lot of people, you know, come to me and say, oh, so why you call yourself a man of God? What? I have never called myself a man of God. I'm a sinner. What part of that you do not understand, retard? I'm a sinner that the only thing is doing is putting the name of the Lord and Creator of the universe and the world. He told me, I want you to scream, I want you to offend anybody, because I am here, and I am the only one. And I only am obeying. What part of that you don't understand that? I have prophets calling me, I'm the cutting edge of the future of prophets and preachers. Why? Because I'm a sinner. And I'm telling you, you need to recognize who's doing this. Because I need to put myself in the same level that you guys are. Because you are retards. You have no education. They told you, oh, they're going to make the announcement, blah, blah, blah. Oh, you know what? The funds are released, blah, blah, blah. And all that crap. And still nobody has changed. Have you noticed that? Nobody has changed. I have 4 people coming to me. Oh, we're doing these changes in Puerto Rico, Benny. It's happening. Give me the truth. Give me the proof. Nothing. There is no such a proof. So, you either a retard or a big liar. Either one, you lose. Okay? There you go. And when all of us exchange, watch what's going to happen. It's going to be priceless. It's going to be so priceless. Everybody's going to notice, man, all these people being thrown, not getting paid, not getting called. Watch. I got a guy, or a girl, I think, who called me and says, Benny, you know, my mother, called me, and they said, just hold on for the call. I even told her, keep waiting, sweetheart. She has never got a call back again. There you go. You see what I'm talking about? This is what I don't believe, bullcrap. Why? Because I have control of my own brain. I have the ability to not believe bullshit. I have the ability to understand what's going on. So before we exchange, they need to clean that swamp. They need to clean what actually is avoiding for us to have our money. Do you understand that? So all these things are happening, and it's up to you to believe it or not. But I told you, and I told you yesterday on my intel, that the World Trade Organization was getting prepared to welcome Iraq in the market. And today came out today. It came out today. And this is the news. Okay? This is the news from the World Trade Organization. It was posted by John Eagle. The National Committee for the Accession of Iraq to the World Trade Organization discussed ways to support Iraq to complete files of accession. The Minister of Commerce announced that the delegation of the National Committee of Iraq accession to the World Trade Organization, WTO, discussed ways to support Iraq to complete the files of joining the World Trade Organization with representatives of Arab countries and the headquarters of Arab League in Geneva. There you go. Am I saying that? Haven't I said that I always one step ahead, two step ahead, and three step ahead for everybody? Yes, I have. And yet, I got morons telling me that what I said, it is a lie. I got no intel, etc., etc. And I predict the shots before it happens. There's my proof right there. Take a look at the date. And I told you. Okay? So, these are the things that we need to understand. Everybody's synchronizing. Okay? They are synchronizing. That's the reason why Iraq is not revaluing the dinar. Because they are synchronizing. Or what? They are synchronizing of an event. And what is that event? It's the breakthrough. It's the breakthrough that prophet said, the prophets like King Clement said it. It's the breakthrough that I've been talking about, the financial reset. Something's got to fail. So now I got the confirmation from bankers that nothing will collapse. And I mean, not that nothing will collapse, but nothing will interrupt our economy. That the transition, because they call it transition, they don't call it breakthrough. They call it transition. The transition to a new system has already been designed to make it smooth and very less likely to collapse the whole market. Because that was my biggest fear. My biggest fear was us not being able to get money from the ATM, not be able to go to the bank, see all these riots on the street, because if you cut off the money from people, guess what's going to happen? Chaos and panic, right? Right. So when I gave, because I couldn't even speak, because I'm basically recovering right now, I posted two videos, once in Spanish and one in English, telling people to cover up, take your money away from your bank accounts. Do whatever you can to protect yourself. Because I knew it was something to happen. I know it still is going to happen very soon, okay? But I was afraid that many of all of you, and I'm talking about everybody, even my enemies, okay? You need to cover up. Because I wanted to know, you know, I don't wish people to just be starving or not being able to even drink water or anything like that. No, I'm not that kind of asshole. Okay, but I need to warn everybody, and the reason why I did not do it on YouTube was because I was so sick, I just forgot about it. I had a fever. So now they told me, because if bankers know this stuff, trust me, it's happening. Okay, if bankers know that something's going on and somebody's going to get arrested, it's because it's happening. Believe it or not. So they told me now, no, Benny, you know what? I understand that. That's basically everybody's concern. That the whole collapse will basically interrupt your daily living. You're not going to be able to go to work because, you know, works or your employer won't be able to pay you, etc., etc. It's going to be a total collapse. It's going to be a total chaos and panic. Because, you know, it takes time for something to be corrected. And that is called basically the corruption coming. Okay? So they tell me now, that these things needs to be done in such a way. So they designed it. You can tell now that these people designed it now. Okay? And And I'm going to respond, before I go on with my discussion, I'm going to respond to many people because they already get offended because I use profanity right now. If you don't like it, you can leave. Okay? I'm not here for your approval. How many times have I said it? I'm going to call it like it is. If you don't like it, you can leave. Somebody got to tell you the truth. The truth has never been convenient. It has never, ever, ever, ever. I don't care if I hurt your feelings. I don't care if I hurt your feelings, honey. This is not for you. Why are you taking it so personal? Why are you taking it so personal? This is not for you, obviously. So why are you taking it so personal? This is for the morons up there. This is the thing about what I've been talking about. We're living in a condition that, oh no, I'm offended. Stop. Nobody's putting anybody's gun on their head for my donations. Nobody. So therefore, I'm free to talk the way I wanted to talk to. And if I get pissed because people believe in the Dragon Family instead of my Lord, that's my wish, not yours. So if you are offended, leave. You can leave right now. Okay? All right, so I misunderstood you. Good. So, said, you heard my feelings just like Ken Dunn. I cannot speak about that more. He's also a retard. And I don't know why you're taking it so personal, sweetheart. I'm telling you the truth. I don't know why you're getting so personal. It's not for you to get personal. I'm not attacking you. If you feel that I'm attacking you, it's because you're probably doing the same thing. Well, there you go. I got ministers, pastors. I got men of God listening to me. Not one of them have been offended. They're probably offended because I'm using profanity. But guess what? They know I'm putting my Lord in front of it. And I don't care if you don't like it. You can get the hell out. I'm going to put my Lord in front of me, and he's going to judge me the way I put his name in front of me, because I don't care. Anybody who is praising the Dragon Family will be judged, just like he's going to judge me. Trust me. That's my main point. That is my main point. Okay? So, don't get offended because of my language. Psychologists use it all the time. I have a degree in psychology. Believe it or not. What do you think psychologists do to change the condition, the mentality condition of their clients by using profanity? They need to slap the face out of them. Wake up. What you're doing is basically destroying yourself. You are destroying yourself. Stop, and they start using profanity. You don't believe me? There's a lot of shows on the YouTube. Go and see. I'm not making this up. Okay? So, my education, I need to put in the same level of those people who do not wants to see another reality. I told everybody, and this is a reminder because I know I never contradict myself. I said, when we jump to a new reality, it's because God will bring us back to biblical times. How can I say that? God brought us right now in biblical times. Guess what's happening? Right now, everybody's praising the enemy of God. They're praising an enemy of God. And just wait, because if we are living biblical times, guess what's next? The tribulation. It's going to take several years, but we are going to meet that. And then we are going to be persecuted. Watch. Because everything that is written in the Bible will come true. But right now, this moment, being a Christian, They look at you like a retard. They look at you like a fanatic. They look like you that you are the fault of all the world. Tell me if I tell you that a lie. You've been right now in your own country being accused of all the bad things happening right now. Why? Because you believe in the Prince of Peace. Because you believe and you support the law. You support a constitutional president that was voted and elected. You are the criminal. All of us are the criminal. Not them. That's the truth. Okay? So, if you think you're not being persecuted for being a Christian, think again. You are being persecuted because you are Christian. Right now, on your own soil. This is the reason why Donald Trump needs to clean that up. And let me just tell you something about Hillary Clinton. This is something that you need to remember. This. Hillary Clinton is going to make a testimony that is going to shake the Democratic Party. It was prophesied by King Clement. Search it. Why Hillary Clinton was going to make a testimony that will shake the Democratic Party. Because she herself will tell the whole world how corrupted she was and she is and how corrupted it is the Democratic Party. It was prophesied by King Clement. Do your research. Okay? So that is coming. Because she knows that if she does not testify, she will go to prison. She's going to try to avoid to go to prison by gaining sympathized by the people. Trust me, there are people up there, so they are so retarded, they look at her like a hero, like a royalty. Okay? So when they see this criminal coming up on national TV and make her a testimony, yes, I did this and this and that, trust me, these people will say, oh, do you see? She's such a noble person. Do you see that? She's such a noble queen. Oh, God bless her. Watch. Watch. Because these people are filthy, filthy smart. They know how to destroy your brain. And just wait until Obama come out of the closet. Wait while. Just been telling you this. When Obama come out of the closet, they will make it look like, oh, my God. He's another hero. Look, he sacrificed his own life and become a president. And look, there was nothing wrong. He was a good president. Watch. That's how they distortion your reality. They want to just switch your reality to make an evil look like an angel. Watch. It's coming. It's coming. I'm just telling you, it's coming. Okay? So, all right, so basically, these things are happening right now in front of us. For the next 48 hours, oh my God, what should I say 40 hours? They're going to throw it on my face. There you go again, Benny, another 40 hours. There you go again, Benny, another 24 hours. You know what? I'm not going to say anything. Let it be, right? Let it be, okay? I don't care anymore. Let it be. All I can tell you is this. All of you are going to be shocked. All of you. Every single one will be shocked. Even myself. Okay? This thing is beautiful. All you got to do is just sit down and watch the whole drama. Watch the whole show develop in front of you. It's going to be precious. It's going to be priceless how things will develop. Coming from Hillary Clinton being indicted or not, whatever happened. Because I've been told that they're going to really try to indict her and bring it to prison. All the way from Obama and the Democrats and also some Republicans that are part of this establishment, that, you know, including, watch this, including people with a lot of influence in Hollywood. Everything's gonna go down to the drain. Watch. It's gonna be so dramatic. All right? It was gonna be beautiful. These things are coming out from the bankers. I know it's coming. All right? So let's talk about the Iraq and what's coming for next week. For why I know is that they're still going to try to trigger the revaluation of the Iraqi dinar by next week and the next week. Okay? So in the last 2 weeks of November, they were still trying to do something in the financial system to trigger the revaluation of the Iraqi dinar and the other currencies. By, you know, introducing the breakthrough, basically, introducing the correction, all right, that was already done and rewritten back in October 18. Watch how I don't forget things, okay? Because that was, October 18 was a very important day. A very important day. Okay? So, back in October 18, they decided we're going to rewrite the system, and we done it. Saying all of a sudden, Jim Rickards said it's going to be on October 15, but it actually happened on October 18. Okay, so I'm just letting you know, things are coming right now, and everything is working out. Jim Rickards is already calling for the gold standard. He keeps repeating the same thing. Just look around, go to YouTube. He's giving interviews left and right, and he's telling everybody, watch out, the gold will go high, will go very high. And that's exactly what we're seeing. We're seeing all these changes in gold, and eventually will sky high, just like cryptos. And before I forget something, let me just tell you something about cryptos. I'm going to start doing, for all those people who are in my list, I'm going to send you the email by, hopefully the latest by Friday, okay? Hopefully by the latest by Friday, I will send everybody your email, which I will, right now I'm working on your demonstration and trading of cryptocurrencies, what is crypto, what cryptos are and what they are not, and all, and try to basically give you the best trading I can give you, okay? I'm not a professional trader, but I've been trained by a professional trader, and I've been told what to say and what to not say, and so people can understand the reality of this whole environment and how can that indeed help you to actually quit your job if you want to. But you need to apply yourself, okay? If you are emotional, this is not for you. I'm going to repeat that again. If you are a person that are too emotional, this is not for you. There's a lot of ups and downs in trading cryptocurrencies, ups and down, okay? Because cryptocurrencies are volatile. They're very unstable and unpredictable, all right? Cryptocurrencies are very unstable and unpredictable. It can go high, all the way to the sky. In less than 4 hours, go down. Or the next day can go down thinking, okay, I'm going to sell my currencies. And then you know that you have nothing to sell. That's the way it is. So you need to be, if you're the kind of person that you understand the situation, if you're the type of person that will listen to good recommendations, if you listen to a moron telling you, don't let anybody tell you how much money you want to invest, get out. I'm not the kind of moron or retard. You only invest the money you can afford to lose. That's it. All right? As a matter of fact, you can even become a millionaire with less than a couple of dollars, believe it or not. I will teach you that by facts in my training. Okay? So, I will send you all the emails. I'm going to do the email blasting for all the people who sign up for my training. And after that, I will also show you how to manage, how to understand the graphs. The graphs is everything. Don't believe anybody. Don't believe anyone about a cryptocurrency or about a coin or whatever is in the market. The graphs are everything. They don't lie. If you want the truth, nothing but the truth besides my Lord Jesus Christ, the graphs are everything. You need to learn how the graph is by history and how is the tendency. Okay? Remember those terminologies because I'm going to show you what is history, what is tendency, what is support, etc., etc. All right, guys? So you're going to be the best trained. I done good money right now because all the training that I've been receiving from my friend, I've been doing good money now. Would it take you a long time to learn more? Of course, everything is about experience, okay? Of course, you're going to have to spend more time and learn. You're going to have to learn the hard way. The beginning, I lost money because I thought it was going to do this and this, but because I forgot my training, I forgot what he told me. He told me specifically step by step, and I did not follow it because I thought I knew better. Well, guess what? You don't know crap. You got to follow the experts. You got to follow their recommendations. And I'm doing that right now. And since I've been doing it, I've been getting money. Okay? So, I want to also thank everybody for your prayers, your good wishes, because of my health. Yesterday, I went to my friend's funeral services. It was really beautiful. Everybody cried. It was a very emotional moment. But that's the way it is because, you know, when you detach from somebody you love so much, it is very difficult. Everybody knows about this. So also want to thank everybody who donated me. And also I want to thank everybody for their beautiful, beautiful words to me. Thank you. I'm not going to do a Spanish show because of my voice. As you can see right now, it's breaking down. So I need to take one more day so I can, you know, do my show again on Tuesday. So Tuesday will be my next show. Don't expect it for me to do a show Monday unless something very important happens. If something really important happens on Monday, I will do my show. But if not, I will do it on Tuesday, which is a schedule for me to do it. So that's it, guys. So thank you so much for your attention. Let me just go back over here. Let's see if you guys have a question. Let me see if you guys have any questions. Well, you know, you have your own, you have, there's people here, like I said, you know, people don't agree with my methods. I totally understand. But guess what? I'm doing it because I get emotional because if you only see the things that I see, you probably do the same thing. Let's look at the facts who all have indictments in the Russia investigation. Facts, not just Fox News. Ex-Ambassador George Papadopoulos pleads guilty over Kremlin contacts. Paul Manafort and Rick Gates plead not guilty to money laundering and fraud. Yeah, you know, all you got to do is just look at the facts, you know. When they tell you about, the latest intel, the so-called intel for this retard saying that Donald Trump was, he was going to step out and leave down for. And I see, and not only that, I see the quantity of people praising, oh my God, oh, thank God for the new republic. And you see all these people, and I'm telling you the truth. I saw this posting, and there were 75 people praising that lie. They really believe it. It was like, wow, man. And this is what I'm going to talk about in my book, After We Are Beat. I'm going to write a book. And I take pictures of that. And, you know, I know I'm going to make a lot of people pissed. But somebody got to really say it. Somebody got to really show the whole world how people believe in bullcrap. They're really easy to believe everything. People believe everything, believe it or not. And what happened? See, I'm an old school. I'm old school, okay? Back in my time when I was younger, we didn't believe anything. We actually, you know, we actually give ourselves some time and say, hey, would that be, you know, would that be a real truth? You know, let's find out about it. We actually took the time to find out if it was a lie or it was truth. Today, that's not the case. Anybody can come out with anything and immediately people believe it. Say, oh my God, the world's going to end tomorrow. That's the truth. Okay? So, this is the things that I have to deal with every day. So my show will be recorded. Don't worry about it. You can listen to it from the beginning. As of right now, it is only live broadcasting. That's it. I apologize for my people in Spanish. A todos ustedes, discúlpenme, pero no puedo hacer el show en español por mi voz. What I'll do is by Tuesday, I'll do my first show will be in Spanish to make up for the people in Spanish, because right now I cannot even start. You can hear from my voice that it's going down again. My doctor told me not to speak for at least 3 days. So as you can see, I did it because a lot of people have been asking me when you're going to go on live, when you're going to go on live. And I really appreciate that you guys are expecting me and waiting for my show. Thank you so much. For now, thank you guys. I really feel good about this. This is good. This is a good feeling. This is a tremendous feeling. And I have a feeling, again, I have a feeling something's going to happen tonight. So I leave you guys with this song. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy your Sunday. Go and praise my Lord Jesus Christ, please. Praise him and love him, because we all going to have a very shocking week. Trust me. I love you guys. I see you next week. Bye-bye now. I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be. Tonight's gonna be a good night.
that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night.
Hey,
let's live it up.
Let's live it up.
I got my money.
Hey,
let's spin it up.
Let's spin it up.
Go out and smash it.
Smash it.
Like on my god.
Like on my god.
Jump out that sofa.
Come on.
Let's kick it off. Fill up my cup.
Drink.
Mazel tov.
L'chaim.
Look at her dancing.
Move it, move it.
Just take it off. Let's paint the town.
Paint the town.
We'll shut it down.
Shut it down.
Let's burn the roof.
And then we'll do it again.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
And do it. And do it. Let's live it up. And
do it.
And do it.
And do it.
Do it. Do it.
Do it.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Do it.
Let's do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Here we come. Here we go. We gotta rock. Easy come. Easy go. Now we on top. Feel the shot. Body rock. Rock it. Don't stop.
Party every day, and I'm feeling that tonight's gonna.